summertime, it can be in the high 90s up to 100. These guys are half sideways. Totally fine. Sheila could be 12. So you guys have any questions? Anything you want to know?
How much is he?
What's the question?
Eggs? So their eggs are the size of a big chicken egg. They're not that big. When we have a little baby penguin hatch up, it's only about that big. He's right upon your hand.
Actually, you gotta stand up.
How?
Down there.
Doesn't stay that low. That
how big. Old is he?
So they'll be full size.
Let him finish. Then he can ask you a question, okay?
They grow very quick.
Now go. No.
60, 65
no.
grams
not yet.
To 6 or 7 pounds.
How much is he?
How old is he?
How old is he?
Benjamin.
He is
Benjamin.
4 and a half, 5 years old.
What?
Oh, that tag?
So if you have a question,
so
you need to raise your hand. Can we do that? If you have a question,
all
right?
They all look very similar. You can tell quite a few of them apart from their markings. All the little dots on them, and even some of just the way the white and black meet, are very, they really stand out on something. When we're feeding 35 penguins really fast, that's pretty much a bang tag. So we can just yell the number out, what kind of fish they ate, and of course we can record what they ate. So just nice quick reference way to look. So how big is he? He's about 7 or 8 pounds. He's probably closer to 8 pounds. And he's pretty big. So this one is a male. And an easy way for you guys to be able to figure out with these guys and our little blue penguins, if that number band is on the right wing, it's a male. If it's on the left wing, it's a female. So it's a quick way for you guys to be able to tell.
I think that penguin wants to go to his cage.
That's a little baby. So he's about 4 and a half, 5 years old. But it's... So you're going to tell whether male or female, you can put the band.
And when they tell you, yep,
to find out initially,
you can ask that question. Okay. Thank you.
DNA test. There is no way to look at them and know whether they're male or female. So the way we used to do it was we would wait until they're about 5 or 6 years old, make sure they're really healthy, big, robust, and we would take a sample of blood, do a full physical, full workup, and we would send part of that blood sample off to find out whether it's male or female. That means going 5 to 6 months with naming a penguin, not knowing whether it's going to be a boy or a girl. So we've had the change. Cornelius became Cornelia. Pumpkin, thankfully, could just stay Pumpkin, but yeah, we've had to change quite a few. We found a new way. We actually started working with a different lab, and we can find out now within about 2 weeks. And the way they do it is we don't have to draw blood. They can actually just take dead. They can actually extract DNA from the membrane of the egg and find out.
Yeah, don't touch him, but don't be scared. That's a question. That's a question.
So, yeah, you just gotta do a blood test. You gotta do DNA. No way to tell. Got a question, Mom?
And what does he eat?
So, what does he eat? That's a good question. He eats all kinds of fish. So we give him penguin, herring, trout, sometimes we give him different kinds of smelt, and squid. So all the fish they get is restaurant quality. So if you've ever had calamari, it's the exact same calamari that you guys are eating, except it's not cut up, battered, and deep fried. But these guys, they definitely have taste preferences. Some of them will wait until a trout comes out, or they're going to wait for a squid to come out. But they can eat about 20% of their body weight a day. So that means me eating over 160 quarter pound of hamburgers in one day. What's that? Oh, in there? So that's just a carrier. That's just how I get them out here. Right now, they're living in a building, a bunch land. They got two big pools. So he was actually swimming. I had to call him out of the water. Thankfully, he comes here. Top two.
Do they have boxes like the little blue penguins?
What's that?
Do they have boxes like the little blue penguins?
Yep. So yeah, they've got little areas where they can go to nest. Inside the building, what we have for them right now is we just
pick up nests. For sharks.
And they pick a territory.
Keep going.
And
that was fun.
They don't have any other penguin near it.
So they don't have a box like
that. No, yeah, they don't have a box all the time. But if they are starting to look like they might lay an egg, we'll move them to a separate area. And we pretty much, we use this thinner plastic. We make a dome. And then we get a litter box. Fill it with the recycled newspaper litter. And we can make a nest out of that. We'll dig down in it, make a nest. We'll give them fake aquarium plants. So that's kind of what they would collect and make a nest out of. We tried lots of different things. That so far seems to be their favorite. It seems to be the most successful for hatching out chicks. We're having less broken eggs, more success with other rearing chicks. So they're working very well. How do we know what they like to eat? So as we're feeding all of them, just put it out, and they can have whatever they want. So after a while, we start to learn which penguins like what. So you might try to hand one for one. They just got to make a face, and they kind of shake their head a little bit. Try another fish. You know, oh, that one I know likes this fish. I'm going to throw that one to that one. Some of them really like squids. We know which ones to feed the squid to. If they don't like it, spit it out. How long do they live? So these guys will live in their natural habitat in Africa, maybe into their late teens or early 20s. In zoos and aquariums, you add about 10 years to that. So
wow.
Late 20s, early mid-30s. Our oldest one here is 30 years old. You're on the younger side.
Now's the time to ask
him. So yeah, they can go to the bathroom a lot. On average, 10 to 15 minutes.
Oh my God.
So they're eating 20% of their body weight. They're getting rid of a lot of it too. Yeah, you're messy. These guys, they definitely do have their own little personalities. Every single one of them is an individual. This guy's my little buddy. I can't say that for every single penguin out there. I can pick him up very easily. I can pet him. Other biologists might try to do that with him. So they definitely bond with specific people. And they tend to have favorites. So he's my buddy. So I like to bring him back.
You got a question over here.
How are we doing? They're hungry? So, these guys are called self-regulators. That means when they're hungry, they'll eat. If they're not hungry, they won't. So, we feed these guys 3 times a day. So, any of those beans, they can come over and eat as much as they want. So, sometimes some penguins will come over a lot in the morning. Maybe only have 1 or 2 at lunch, and then they'll eat a lot again at dinner. Some of them, they don't like to eat anything in the morning, they'll just eat at lunch and dinner. So we give them 3 chances to eat, and they can eat any of those, but they don't have to eat it every day.
So is number 86 still alive?
86, 87?
86.
Probably not.
I don't know if
you... You want to see sure it was 86?
Yeah, it was 86.
How about 87?
87 is alive and well.
Alright, maybe it's 87.
His name was Liberty.
Yeah, oh, that's it. That's it. That's
okay, alright, good.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh, oh, keep your hand up.
Yeah, yeah, Liberty's still alive.
Liberty's still alive.
Right. How old is Liberty, do you know?
Oh, he's probably in his mid-to-late teens.
Sorry.
Okay. I'm just your personal space.
Got some time? All right, yeah.
When you come back in the summer, he'll still be alive?
Oh, yes, he was still be here.
All right.
When you come back, though, you'll have to ask his number. How's changed your numbers? Originally, their numbers were what we call their accession numbers. So it's the number animal they are coming into the aquarium.
Oh.
So we had our lowest penguin was 5. Our highest penguin was in like the 5,000s. So it's getting really hard when you're trying to spit out a bunch of numbers throwing feeds.
Sure.
Excuse me. Bye bye. guys. See you in the next video.